I'm mad. I think we should all be mad, and our state leaders should be mad.
Activist Erin Brockovich at the state capitol today demanding that survivors of California's wildfires be paid in full by PG&E, despite the utility's potential filing for bankruptcy protection.
Nobody expects them to shut the power down to 16 million people. That's not going to happen. But we have to make everyone whole, and here's the change. Stop giving them a pass.
I'm hardworking, and I'll do anything, and I'm not leaving here without a job.
Brockovich, portrayed here by Julia Roberts, first came to fame in this 2000 film named after her. The movie chronicles her successful lawsuit against PG&E after she raised concerns about water contamination in a small Southern California town. Now Brockovich is battling for people like Beth Hoffman, a Paradise resident whose mobile home park went up in flames from the campfire with no insurance.
I don't see how someone can be so negligent to all these people and be able to just walk away free.
PG&E faces potentially up to $30 billion in claims, and lawyers representing the fire survivors claim California's biggest utility has plenty of money to pay those claims in full.
PG&E has well over $70 billion in assets, plus a guaranteed income stream that provides it over $1 billion per year in profit.
In a statement, PG&E says, "We understand and recognize the serious concerns raised by customers and wildfire victims, and we acknowledge that while we have made progress, we have more work to do. We're open to a range of solutions that will help make the energy system safer." The California legislature can't prevent PG&E from declaring bankruptcy, but lawmakers can apply pressure in different ways, according to Jim Patterson, who sits on the Assembly Utilities Committee.
And I think that it's going to be up to the legislature to try to encourage the bankruptcy court to make people whole. They need to be at the table. But at the same time, assets of PG&E may very well be sold off.